Hello everyone, this is Marika Lamro, and this video is going to explain how to calculate your current grade. I know that most students are pretty stressed out when they think about their own grades, so I wanted to use this floral background that I think is pretty soothing to help you stay calm or as calm as possible while thinking about your grades. So there are three things that I would like to discuss before we get into the sample calculations. The first is that all the examples in this video are going to come from syllabi that use points and not percentages. So on my syllabi, I say things like quizzes are worth 4 points and exams are worth 20 points and the final project is worth 30 points and things like that. But in other classes, other faculty might say things like quizzes are worth 10% of your final grade, exams are worth 50% of your final grade, the final project is worth 15% of your final grade. And so if you're in a class where the syllabus uses percentages, this video might not be as helpful to you, although I think it could still help you understand how to calculate your current grade. The next is that I think it's important that you keep track of your current grades throughout the semester. Unfortunately, it's been my experience that a lot of students don't really know how they're doing in their classes, and they kind of come to the end of the semester without really understanding what their grades are. And that means a lot of students have an unpleasant shock when they get their final grade because the grade isn't as high as they were expecting it. And that really sucks, and I don't want that to happen to you. So what I recommend is that you keep track of your grades throughout the semester. I use an Excel file, and you can just update the Excel file every time you get a new grade, and that will tell you whether you're on track to get the grade you want or if you need to be dedicating more time to the class to get better grades. And the last thing to tell you is kind of a secret, and that is it really doesn't reflect well on a college student when the college student asks the instructor, "What is my current grade?" And that's because we pretty much, in this society, expect that college students should be able to calculate their grades on their own. So if a student emails a faculty member to say, "I don't know what my current grade is, can you tell me what it is?" That student is saying one of a few things. That student is saying either, "I don't have the math skills to calculate my final grade or my current grade," or, "I don't have the critical thinking skills to calculate my current grade," or, "I don't really feel like dealing this myself. I'm feeling kind of lazy and I want you to do it for me." As you can understand, none of those things look good for the student. And as students, you really want to cultivate a reputation for professionalism. And one of those things is knowing how to calculate your own grades. And so when you watch this video, my hope is that from watching this video, you will understand how to calculate your own grades, and you will not need to email or ask your instructors what your current grades are, and you will be able to continue to cultivate this reputation of professionalism. Now, I want to clarify that I am not saying that you should never ask your faculty member questions. In my classes, I always want students to ask me if there's anything about the content that's confusing, because my job is to make sure that students understand the content from the class. And if the students don't, I want to make sure that they do understand it. So I'm not saying all questions are inappropriate. I'm saying this particular question, "What is my current grade?" doesn't reflect well on students and doesn't indicate a professionalism that we like to see in students. So here's an example from a syllabus of the points that the final grade is coming from. And in this class, there are 6 homeworks and 3 exams, and you can see how much each thing is worth. So the first thing that you need to do when you're trying to figure out what your current grade is you need to go and look at your syllabus and find in your syllabus where it says how many points each thing is worth. The next thing that you need to do is you need to go and figure out how many points you've earned on the different assignments thus far. So let's look at an example. Let's say that you have completed 3 homeworks and 1 exam so far, and here are your grades on those assignments. The next thing you need to know is how many points could you have earned on those assignments, and that you can get from the syllabus. So you can see that each homework is worth 3 points, and that exam is worth 10 points, and so you put that into the best possible grade column. So you've earned 16.25 points so far, and you could have earned 19 points so far. So that means you've earned 16.25 out of 19 points. So your grade is a 16.25 divided by 19, which is an 85.5%, which is a good, respectable grade. So now let's imagine it's later in the semester, and we'll look at what you would do when you have more grades. So let's pretend that it's right before the final exam. You've done everything so far and you want to know what your grade is going into the final exam. So you've earned all the grades for all the homeworks and the 2 exams, and you know that you've earned 34.25 out of 38 points. So that means that your grade is a 90.1%, which is a great grade going into a final exam. And if that's your grade, you should feel really proud of yourself. So as you go through the semester, you should just update your table. Like I said, when I was an undergraduate, I used an Excel file. So you can update Excel and you can keep track of your grade as you go throughout the semester. And you just keep adding rows and columns for every time an assignment, you get an assignment grade back. And you can just really easily track how well you're doing. And like I said, I think it's really important that you do that so that it helps you make sure that you're on top of how you're doing throughout the semester and whether you need to take more time and dedicate it to your class. So here's an example from a different class. This class has a participation grade, 3 papers, and a presentation grade. And you can see that there are 30 days when you can earn participation points, and each participation point is worth a half a point. And the total points towards your grade is 10 points. So what's happening is 30 times 0.5 would be 15, but the faculty member is actually only counting 10 of those points. So what's happening is the faculty is dropping your lowest participation days. So maybe some days you won't be there, or maybe some days you won't have your best comments in class. And the faculty member is taking that into consideration and is not going to count all of that against you as long as you earn your 10 points. But when you're calculating your current grade, that's actually not something that we really take into consideration. We'll take it into consideration when we consider the best possible grade, which is another video that you can watch of mine. But when we're looking at the current grade, it's not something we really need to focus much on. So the first thing we need to do is figure out how many participation points we've earned. So there has been 15 days of class, and this is how many points we've earned so far. So we've earned a total of 5 points so far in the class. And if we put all of that into our table, we know that we've earned 5 points. Our best possible participation grade at this point would be 7.5, because we've had 15 days of class, and 15 times 0.5 would be 7.5. And those are the 2 grades that we've earned on the first 2 papers. So we know that we have a 43 out of 57.5. So the grade is a 74.8%. So here is an example from a self-paced architecture class, where everything is due at the end of the semester. When I was an undergraduate, I had a lot of friends who were architecture majors, and they had a lot of classes where all of their work was due at the end of the semester. So here's a sample syllabus from one of those classes. And in that class, there are 10 homeworks and 5 projects. So let's take a look at what the work could look like. So you've done so far 5 homeworks and 3 projects, and those are the grades that you've gotten. So you have 35.25 out of 40 points, which means you have an 88%. So that's pretty straightforward. But let's consider that everything is due at the end of the semester, and what matters is how much work you've done versus how much work you have left to do. And one of the problems that I find is when students are in classes like this, they inflate their expectation for how they think they're going to do at the end of the semester because they only consider what the grades have been on the work they've done, and they don't consider how much work they have left to do. So let's look at kind of the best way to handle it when you have a class where you have some or all the work that's due at the end of the semester. So what you should do is calculate your current grade and calculate what your grade would be if you didn't do any more work in the semester. So that's what this would look like. So you can see that you have a bunch of zeros for all the rest of the work. And you can also see this 18 that I have circled. So if you had two points per homework assignment, normally that would mean that you had a possible points of 20 points for your homework assignment. But actually what's happening is the teacher is automatically dropping one of those assignments, your lowest one. And so you're actually going to have 18 points counting toward your final grade. So it's important if you have a class like this where the teacher is automatically dropping your lowest grade that you remember to take that into consideration when you're looking at how many points you would earn total. So if you remember, your current grade at the moment is an 88%. But if it was the last day of the semester and you didn't complete any other work, your final grade would be a 35.25 divided by 68, which is a 51.8%. So you can see there's a pretty big difference between those two grades. One is a respectable grade, one is a grade you don't want to get. And one of the challenges when you're teaching a class where you have an assignment that isn't due until the end of the semester is that students will ask how they're doing in the class, and it's kind of hard to tell them because you could tell them their current grade, but you could also tell them what their final grade would be, and one isn't really the correct answer. It's kind of, you need to know both of those things. So when you're taking a class where something is due at the end of the semester, you really should calculate both of these things. Calculate your current grade and calculate what your final grade would be if you didn't do any more work. So for example, if you were taking intro psychology, you might have a research participation grade where you have to complete a certain number of research participation projects by the end of the semester. And so it would be in your best interest to both calculate your current grade and calculate what your final grade would be if you didn't earn any more research participation points. And then you'll know that your final grade is going to fall somewhere between what your current grade is and what your final grade would be if you didn't do anything else. So we're at the end of this video, and I know that some of you might be thinking, okay, I know how to calculate my current grade, but I really want to know what my best possible grade would be. So can I still get an A in this class, or can I still pass this class? And if you have that question, I have a video that addresses that very question, and I encourage you to watch it.